This time, we will look at how to transfer data from an Excel-based room schedule into the model using Linear. A room schedule usually contains information about the usage description of each room, which has been agreed upon with all parties involved, so the owner, the architect, and the engineer, for example. In our case, we find information about the conceptualized area of each room, as well as the number of people who are scheduled to use that room at the same time. Also, we will find the number of sanitary items for each room. We now want to transfer these information into our model and transfer them to the MEP spaces, as well as display them in a room schedule in Revit. In preparation, I've already created shared parameters for the included information and assigned them to the MEP spaces. How this works is clearly explained in the Revit help. These then also appear in the properties dialog of the MEP spaces. In addition, I've already created a room schedule and linked the related parameters here. Now everything is ideally prepared to perform a trouble-free import of these data. For this, I use the Excel import function in the linear ribbon. Now I select the Excel with the room schedule information and load it into the project. In order to be able to react flexibly to different formatting, I can now define in the preferences where the relevant data can be found in the Excel list. As mode, I select the room allocation and then specify on which sheet of the Excel file the information can be found, as well as the row in which the headline of the table is located. Finally, I specify the position of the first data set I want to import. If we take a look at our example, we see that the header row of the table is in row number 3, and the first relevant data is in column 1 in row number 4. So I will add this here. Next, the dialog for room allocations opens. Here we use one or more parameters to create a unique mapping between the rooms in the Excel file and our MEP spaces in the model. In my example, all MEP spaces can already be uniquely identified by the room number, which is already stored as a parameter at the MEP spaces. Now I can match the room number from the Excel file with the room number in my model. So I select the corresponding parameter and now all 68 rooms can already be uniquely assigned. If this is not the case, several parameters can also be matched to enable a one-to-one assignment at the end. After this assignment, I now determine which parameters should be transferred from the Excel into our model. Since the room name is also already contained in my model, I'm only missing the area, the person, and the sanitary objects here. I can now assign these parameters to the previously created shared parameters. So I do that here now for all 6 parameters I want to import. So I assign the parameter for the area, as well as for the persons, the wash basin, the showers, the toilets, and the urinals. When all parameters are assigned, I can start the import. All data will now be automatically transferred to the corresponding MEP spaces and will also appear in the properties. Let's take a look. So now we can see that, for example, in the sanitary area, all contained sanitary objects appear, and also the corresponding numbers of persons for the rooms are assigned. I can then use this information in my design process, for example, to take the persons into account when calculating the cooling load. Likewise, all imported values now also appear in our room schedule, which was dynamically created using the MEP space parameters. In the next video, we will show how other parameters can be edited outside of Revit and then transferred back into the model. That's workflow instead of workaround.